in Zagreb, and in Zagreb you can't feel poverty like in other parts of Croatia. I think that we are all making a mistake and talking about poverty in big cities, because we all know that in big cities, especially in the center of the city like we are standing now, you can see the bigger picture of poverty, especially in Croatia. In Croatia you really need to move a bit, especially on the east, to see the roots of poverty in Croatia.
If you were to tell me a story about poverty in Croatia, what is it like for you? What is the story of Croatia and poverty? What's the situation?
The situation. I don't have statistics, but actually situation is not at all good. So many people working for minimum salary. So many jobs is how to say, in gray zone, you know. They don't pay everything on your account, they pay you in cash from hand to hand. This is a main problem. Many overworking hours didn't pay. So many problems.
What has to change in Croatia to make things better?
It has to be changed, to be better. Simply, government have to really, really, really be strict on, let's say, contract between employee and the
worker.
Mm-hmm. Have to be really strict.
Yep.
And simple and strict. It's about the government, you know, and in people who are now in parliament, because they are those kind of persons who can make some laws, you know, some rules and regulations for working time, for taxes, for whatever. Not me, not you, in parliament, in Croatia, in parliament.
Is a decent minimum income important in Croatia?
Well, as we said before in our roundtable today, we have really big numbers of citizens that are in need, that are in risk of poverty. 20% of our population is in risk of poverty, and the minimum income scheme covers just 12% of them, and covers just the 1/3 of those in risk of extreme poverty. We spend just 0.3% of our budget on social protection. So we think if we just double this amount, it won't be much of our budget to spend on social help for those who are in need.
If you had one message for your government, what would it be?
I would say they should listen more to poor people living in Croatia. There are a big amount of citizens, and just to imagine themselves living in conditions like that. I don't know if they can imagine life like that, but they should go to people. They should really go to people, firstly when they are doing their campaign, and to hear what problems are, and then maybe they could change something. They could have this will to change something, really.
Yeah. Thank